Tonight. That's right. All right. We have one of our very own tonight as our speaker, Miss Katrina King. That's right. And what are you for?
Everyone remember to silence their cell phones.
But not before they.
Check in at the Rock Bible study on the
Facebook. Check in on the Facebook. Just like your grandmother does.
No, no.
Or, you know, check in on the Instagram or the Twitter, take a picture and let them know where you're at. So, also tonight we have Food by Christ Episcopal Church, and we have chili with corn chips, fresh fruit, and nutty buddy bars. So, very good.
Speaking of food, whenever you're done eating, try cleaning up, clean up after yourself, because you can get pretty messy back there.
That's right.
Yeah.
If you don't pick your plate up, pick Josiah's plate up, and then Josiah will pick your plate up, and then you can go pick someone else's plate up, you see? It'll all work, because remember, the Rock is awesome, right? Amen. The Rock is awesome, but guess what? Your mama ain't here. All right, now Becky's children, their mom's here. But guess what? She's not cleaned up after me either. Okay, clean up your mess. All right, just take your mess. We don't even expect you to clean up my mess. I'll clean my mess or yours. But if you clean up my mess, guess what I'll do? I'll clean up your mess.
Oh,
and then we just like pay it forward over and over, and I'll just all clean up everybody's mess. All right, you do it. How about you do it for the food we gave you?
I love food.
How about that? How about that? That's a good deal. All right. Well, everybody, stand. All right. As we are beginning tonight, remember to be thankful for those that are providing our food. Remember to also be thankful for the word that God's given us tonight. And maybe the Lord's given you a little bit of money, you know. We got a little box back there. You can put an offering in for things that the Rock has, or you can put a prayer request in, or you can come up here. We'll pray for you. Whatever it is, remember, the Rock is a place where your needs get met. All right? Your needs get met. So tonight, let's focus and let's pray. Josiah, you want to pray for us?
Oh, listen,
I guess. All right.
Everyone bow their heads with me. All right. Dear God, I pray that you would just bless this service tonight. I pray that you would go before all of us, God. I pray that if anyone out there is just struggling with something that they need to get rid of, a burden that they're carrying on their shoulders that they've been carrying for a long time, God, I pray that you will remove that from their shoulders, God, and just pick them up again and show them, dust them off, show them that you love them, God. I pray that you would just bless the worship and bless Miss Katrina as we go into tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. All right, guys, real quick announcement. I totally forgot this until we were in the middle of this, but in the near future, we're planning on having a kind of fun hangout music night where we're not going to just play, like, you know, the worship songs you hear up here or on the Lighthouse. We're going to be playing some secular music. Okay, but now when I say that, we're going to be playing, like, clean stuff. We're not going to be playing, like, you know, you hear some stuff like, wow, that's so bad, I don't know how like anyone's mom's letting them listen to that. That is so awful. But when we're talking about stuff, you know, like yeah, like you said, like some songs by Journey. But like even like more modern stuff like Taylor Swift or some of the. If you know a song that you really enjoy, okay. The point of this is that I believe there's a suggestion box somewhere back there. I believe I've seen one before. If not, we will find one. And if you have a song you'd like us to possibly play, for the next couple of weeks, I want you guys to write down songs and put them in there so we can learn them. And then we're gonna come on like maybe a Friday or a Saturday, we're gonna hang out here, and we're just gonna rock the house, play some fun music, and we're probably gonna worship in there too. But we just wanna let you know, like, we're not just, we're here to live life with you guys. We're not here just for like the high moments. We're here to like go out and have just, so, you know, sometimes we just need to go and hang out and not feel like we just have to come to this churchy thing where we, it's like, it's all about God, it's all about God, it's all about, and really it is all about God, but God shows up in the ordinary things too. So God can show up when we're singing about how we're never getting back together. We're gonna party like we're 22 or, you know, whatever it is. So all that being said, we are going into worship right now, but we have a really fun set for you tonight. It's really upbeat. We've done some crazy things with some songs, and Matt the drummer, he can tell you that we've been all over him to get this stuff right. So, with that being said, I encourage you guys, this whole space up front is open if you feel like worshiping up here. We want you to be up and moving, and there's clapping. This first song, it has a really incorporated part. Like, everyone needs to be singing this part. So, this is a good song. So sing this to me really. It's oh 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 again. Oh 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 oh. There's a fire that burns inside, a fire that burns inside. Nothing can stop us, we'll be running through the night. There's a fire that burns inside, there's a fire that burns inside. We are the freedom generation, send the mercy. You are the one who sent. Yours is the glory. There's a fire in our hearts and it burns for you. It's never gonna fade away. We are the flame. Yours is the glory. Oh, 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 oh.
Yours is the glory. We are the same.
of sweating in here. All right, if not, you should be. All right.
Yeah. Dear God, thank you for bringing us here tonight. You brought us here to worship you. Thank you for bringing us here. We pray that we would just worship you and hear your voice tonight. Thank you for bringing us in your presence, and thank you for letting us hear Miss King's word tonight.
Your face. my thoughts and words in doing all my days and all my hours. All for Jesus, all my days and all my hours. All for Jesus, all my days and all my hours. Let my hands perform his bidding. Let my feet run in his ways. Let my eyes see Jesus only. Let my lips speak forth his praise. Oh, for Jesus.
Jobs. But, you know, I think Becky and I have been more excited about Katrina speaking than Reggie.
Well, I better do a good job.
Yeah, you better do a good job because, I mean, that's all we could think about was Miss Katrina was in the house tonight. And, really.
Well, I better not disappoint you.
So don't mess up.
I won't. I'll try not. No pressure, guys.
No pressure. You know, guys, when you look around and you see the adults that come here, you know, they come. I pay them a lot to be here. Not. Nobody gets anything.
Hugs. Hugs are worth a million bucks.
Yeah. But all these adults that come out, they come out because you guys are so special that none of us want to be away from you. It's really weird. So if you're listening, that's the truth, Josiah. So if you're listening and you're the parent of one of these, you need to see them here because they are just perfect in every way, in our book. And so, you know, but just come on out. And so, Lord, I do thank you for Katrina. Lord, I thank you for her love for you and her love for these youth. And Lord, I thank you that the anointing is there, the message is there, and Lord, that we're going to receive everything you have for us as we just focus on you tonight and the love you have for us. So thank you for just pouring through Miss Katrina tonight as we give you praise. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's welcome Miss Katrina again.
I want to thank you, and I want to start out in prayer because it's really important. I'm not a pastor for all those that are listening. I'm not a pastor's wife. I'm just an ordinary girl, just like all you sitting here. You're either a boy or a girl, right? And we're just ordinary, but God uses the ordinary to do extraordinary things. And if you believe that to be true, hopefully that's going to happen tonight. So let me start in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, please let the Spirit anoint me. Let the words be your words and not mine. Let anyone that's listening, whether it's an adult or child, let this message speak to them. Let them be able to take something away and let them grow closer to you. Because that's what we're all doing. We just want to grow closer to you in this relationship. And February is the month of love. And I think that's where I'm going. That's where you've led me to go, is to talk about this concept of love. So I ask that you bring your words and the passages, because we always know I forget exactly where those passages are, but I know kind of the words. So use me to be your vessel. I ask all this in your mighty name. Amen. All right, like I said, I'm just an ordinary person. Like I told you before, when I spoke to you and we talked about being fisher of men, right? About going out, we had the netting, we had the little fish, you know, because I'm a teacher and we had to cut out paper and do something, right? That's the teacher in me. So when we went out and we talked about it, and God wants us to go out there and bring others. And I see some new faces today that I haven't seen. Absolutely, I noticed right away. So this is good. Devin, you're not new. All right, maybe your shoes, but not you. All right, so we come here and we want to bring our friends. We need to surround us because, you know, little fish don't travel by themselves, right? They're always in a little school, right? They're going together. So tonight I want to talk to you. My title is Crazy Love. All right, crazy love. So we're going to talk about some crazy stuff tonight. And I want to start with this foundation to see if you believe this is true. In John 4:1, it says, we love because why? You all know this. Because why?
What was that again?
Because God loved us first.
Now, you all knew that. Now, when I said I could start the very beginning of it, and you already knew what it was. We can love because God first loved us. Do you believe that to be true?
Yeah.
All right. That's my whole foundation. If you don't walk out with anything else, then you walk out with that, and that's John 4:1. Right? That's why we're doing this. All right. Now, if I show you some things here, I want to see what your reaction is about this. You're gonna be like, what does this have to do with love? Just stick with me. Just stick with me. You guys stick with me for about 5 minutes. I know your attention span. But if I show you this, look at this big pack of paper. And it's multicolored. All right, now I'm gonna show you this pack of paper.
White paper.
Yes, I did get this from the school, so I had to take it back. The color paper's mine, but this one isn't. But this one is a plain pack of white paper. What do you think about that? Wait a minute.
It's practical.
But this one, you all had a positive reaction, and all it is a pack of colored paper. Okay, now, keep sticking with me. All right, if I show you this, just a marker, very good. But if I show you this, the big pack, now I'm sorry, I didn't have the big 64 pack, but if I show you this, you'd be like, which one's more enticing? Why? It's just a pack of crayons. And if I had the 64 pack and I held up all three, which one would you want? Okay, good. Now you're gonna have to stick with me now. Miss Vicky, please don't get mad at me about what I'm about to do. Cause this ain't gonna be good, but it's okay. All right. All right, if you're listening, hold on. Will you hold this for me?
I need a helper here. All right.
I got you, buddy.
All right, good. Come here. Now help me.
She didn't pick you, Devin.
For those listening on the air, Katrina is throwing paper.
All right, everybody, keep throwing. Come on. Come on. All right, no, don't pick it up. No. I didn't tell you to get up out of your seat. Here's the teacher in me. Get in your seat. What you doing? The bell's rang. Sit down. All right. Now, you thought that pack of paper was cool. Oh, wait a minute. Here, we got to get this down there. We got to get all people. All right. And you thought that pack of paper was cool because it was multicolored.
You like Pringles?
I love Pringles. All right, now, you thought this pack of crayons was cool because it had multiples in them, right? All right, it gets better, Miss Vicky, don't get mad. Please don't get mad at me as I throw all these markers all over the floor. All right, now, did you say you're coming to my class? This is, we do this all the time. All right. No, I'm just joking in case any administrators are listening. All right, now, there's a reason I just took this paper and I took these markers. Our world is full of colors. Do you agree? All these papers make it cool. It makes it interesting, it makes it creative, and so do you. These markers are all different colors because it gives you a choice. And God came to give you a choice. And it's a choice that you make. Do I love or do I hate? It's really easy. Now, what I want you to do on the count of two or three, without hurting each other, and I'm gonna say this lightly, and I'm gonna close my eyes and pretend I don't see you. I want you all to grab a piece of paper of your choice, and I want you to grab a marker of your choice. Go! Last one in their seats are rotten egg, and go get handy. Do you hear it? I wish you could hear it. I wish you could see it. All right. One, two, three. Crisscross applesauce. Zip. All right, good. See, you all remember this from school. Now. Shh. All right, come on. Stick with me or you don't get to eat. The sooner I get done. Oh, see, I know I get your attention. All right, now. I want you, we're talking about love. No, not yet. I only want you to, when I tell you what to do, I only want you to do it on one side. So you have to pick one side of the paper. Just one side. So like an 8.5 by 11, and you just have one side of the paper. Okay. No, one side. The full side. I'm gonna give you this opportunity that you don't get much. I'm gonna give you some little instructions and you use your creativity. You use your mind and you're gonna use your heart. Now, we are commanded, and let me read this to you. There are some verses. One Thessalonian says, "For we know, brother and sisters, loved by God, that he has chosen you because our gospel came to you, and you are simply with words, but also with power, with the Holy Spirit and deep conviction. You know how to live among yourselves. You became imitators of God and of us, for you welcomed the message in the midst of suffering with joy." People suffer and have joy. Suffer, joy. Now, if you were an English teacher, you would tell me there's an opposites, meaning there's a word for it. I don't know what it is because I'm not an English teacher. Anson, there you go. See, we got all kind of good stuff going on in here. All right, now, what I want you to do while I read some other messages is I want you to write, we're supposed to walk in love because we're Christians. I want to throw out that word Christian. Because God didn't call anybody in the Bible Christians. He called them disciples. Disciples gives you a new meaning of showing love. Meaning you have to walk, you have to follow. And it didn't say it was going to be easy. But for this first part of this, I want you to write all the times that people didn't walk in love. When people didn't say things out of love. When people did, their actions didn't show you love. And all of you, whether you are 7 or 8 and listening on the radio, or you're 48, or maybe even older. I bet you can't even comprehend someone could be older than 48, right? Because that's older than a dinosaur. But what if somebody was older than that and, like, I don't know, 70? I know that's a wall. I can't even imagine being 28. I can't even imagine someone being 70. But anyway, I want you to start writing all over the front. You cannot write on the back because we're going to do something different. But I want you to help me out by writing all the times, especially with every one of you being a different age, being a male or female, homeschooled, private schooled, community, public school, whatever we call this thing we're doing. You all have different experiences at different ages. And you all have experienced lots of stuff. So I want you to write down all the things that you've experienced that is not of love. It doesn't make you feel warm and fuzzy. It makes you angry. All the things. You only got a minute. Ready? I want you to write things that you saw on TV. I want you to hear songs that weren't of love. I want you to show people who are mean to you. Someone talking behind your back. Someone stole your homework. All the things when we as grown-ups say mean things to you that are not lifting you up and they're not supportive. When we look at you and give you the evil look. When we write you up and you didn't even do it. Okay, you got it. All the things that are not of love, that if Jesus himself came down and saw your paper, he'd say, nah, that's not what I commanded my people to do. All right? So I want you to write down all the things. You can draw pictures. You can just put a word. Nobody's going to see this, I promise you. This is yours. But it has to come from your heart, things that hurt you. Now, some of us as adults, we have had lived a little bit longer, so we may have experienced a little more things, right? Because we make things complicated. And I'm here to tell you, this is not complicated. Look at the words we sang of these songs. And I wrote a couple of them down because it really triggered me. It says, what did I write them down at? The first song we were saying, God is great. And if he's for us, nothing can stand against us. God is the healer. Do you remember singing that song? Okay, so if you remember that song and you sing with all your heart, then you're gonna say, well, when this happened, that wasn't happening. He wasn't being so great because I'm getting hurt, all right? Then that second song, what kind of words do you think came out of that second song when it says that he is the sinner, lift him up. I called and you answered. Who are you calling to? Jesus. And we know people who are not loving. When things get bad, everybody says, oh God, where's God? Let's pray to God. We need some help, right? Think about it. 9/11, you saw that on TV. Some of you are old enough to remember that.
I was in it.
Some of you were in it, and everybody was coming together. Now where are they at? If all these people were being disciples of Jesus, where are they at? All right, so I'm wondering this. I'm sure you're wondering this as young people, right? Because we're commanded to love. And in 1 Corinthians, Ms. Vicki helped me find, like I said, I'm not really good at memorizing where they're at. I know the words and I can summarize it, but I can't remember exactly where in that Bible it's at. But 1 Corinthians says that out of these things I give you, of faith, hope, and love, love is the greatest. Love, and remember last time I talked to you, love is used more in the Bible than anywhere else. And that is amazing. That he wants us to love, love, love. And it says about, in 2 Thessalonians says, your path is growing more and more, and your love, all that you have for one another, is increasing. In Ephesians 1:11, it says, in him we were chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works everything out and conforming with the purpose of his will, in order that we will follow him. And in 18 it says, I pray that their eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know that the hope in which he has called you reaches his glorious power of those who believe. So all through this Bible, it's telling us all these different passages and trying to put it together. But at your young age, sometimes it's hard, like this doesn't make sense. And we come and preach at you, and I don't want to preach at you. I want to say that this is not hard. There's one God. He gave his one son. His son did not have, it wasn't easy. He showed humility. He walked here as an ordinary person. He faced hurtful things just like you do. He picked ordinary people and called them to follow him as disciples. They weren't ordained. They didn't have any special education. They weren't big money makers. They weren't the people who spent all day learning and had the rules and were the hierarchy and the top lifted people, did he? He called ordinary people, 12 of them, to be his disciples. That's how easy it is. And he said, do you believe in me? Follow me. And they did. They left their homes, they left their families, and they just followed him. And when they do that, because they did it out of love, but then you all experience these hurtful things. Do you have these things written down? Okay, good, good, good. Not that you get hurt. I don't want you to get hurt, but I'm not going to lie to you, and I'm going to be bold, because we prayed before this, and then they told me to be bold. Yes? I need your paper. Well, there's all this paper here, son. Grab one. Yeah, you see? This is like school. When you didn't get the paper, you look around, see someone else is working, and you say, hey, what are you doing? Grab a paper. Grab one. Just grab any of them. Look at this. All right, good. All right, it's all good. Now that you wrote your stuff down, I want you, now this is, again, this is how you all do this, and you're going to be good at it. Because when you don't get a good grade on a test, what's the first thing you do with that test and that piece of paper? Wait. Don't shred it. Okay, that would have been the first one. What's the second thing we would do?
Teacher.
We can't burn it because, see, there's this fire person back there, and we probably break a fire code, even though I would say that's a good idea, burn it. All right, but we're not going to burn it. Now, I want you, we're not going to eat it. That's how you get out of your homework. The dog ate it. No. All right, I want you to take it up and crumble it up because you're mad. You're mad. Show some anger. We don't smile when we're mad. No, we don't eat it. Don't eat it. All right, now, ball it up. You're mad. Does it hurt make you mad? Yes. What? Alright, this boy is taking this literal. And this youngin is stomping on the paper. That's how mad he is because he got hurt. He is stomping it up. That is good. Alright, you're going to get an A on this. You're getting an extra piece of candy. Alright, that is, I don't know what that is. That's some kind of Egyptian writing. Hey, that's good. See, I might learn something. Even a teacher can learn. And I'm learning every day. All right. Now that you balled it up. All right, come on. We got to get you back under order. Remember, you can't go to lunch or go to dinner if we don't get done. Remember? Okay, good. Now, you balled it up and you've expressed anger because hurtful things make us angry. Do you agree? All right. Now, here's the thing. Some of you are young, so you probably don't have a lot of balled up pieces of paper that you're carrying with you. Because you haven't experienced life enough yet to get that many hurtful things to have all this luggage. Now, some of you teenagers that are in high school, if I took you and compared you to the little youngin back there, I bet your paper is filled with a lot more things that are a lot more hurtful than he has. Why do I want to point this out? You know what? God is so smart when he created us. He only gives us a little at a time, to grow us. Do you believe that? And as we get older, our problems get bigger, and he's given us a challenge. And without that challenge, we don't have a testimony, y'all. And all of us adults who have come up here to give you testimonies, it hasn't been pleasant. None of us sit up here and says, my life has been great. I have a butler, a maid. I am richer than all rich. I don't even know why I'm here, because I shouldn't even be standing, because I don't do anything all day. Nobody has said that. Every one of us adults have come to you and said, we have had problems in our life. Lots of problems. And all the problems you've had, they had hundreds of years ago. They just had different names that we can't pronounce in the Bible, all right? Because we were trying to read them in our small group, I can't pronounce them. And my husband loves to pick me out to make me read these things because I can't say them, and I'm the school teacher, I should be able to pronounce, right? This is embarrassing. So now, while I read something to you, a passage that is near and dear to my heart, I want you, if you believe this, and you're ready to do this, and only God can heal. I can't heal your hurts. Miss Vicky can't heal your hurts. Your mom and dad can't heal your hurts. Your best friend can. I promise you that. The only thing we can do is disappoint you, because we're human beings and we will always let you down. Not always, but when you really need us, sometimes we will let you down, because we're human beings. We are not perfect. And that's why we hurt others. It's not intentional. Now, some people are intentional. They're just mean, right? And you say, bless her heart, and then you strangle her. But no. But we can't do that, right? Because we're called to love. And strangling somebody is not showing love. Now, while I read this, come on, get back with me. Come on. See, I set you wild. This is just like my classroom. They are wild as soon as we start playing. Now, I want you to really think about it. If you really believe that Jesus is the Savior, and you've accepted him, and you truly believe these songs that we sang, that he is greater than anything, he can heal everything, and I want Jesus to be at the center. I want you to lift me up high. I want my life to be high above, right? At building 429 says, take this world and give me Jesus. This is not my home. I'm not home yet. This is not your home, you all. And I know that your parents tell you, no, you live at whatever the address is. This is your home. And we teach you that from a little squirt tail on up, right? And you all know that this is where you live. And I'm here telling you, no, you don't live here. This is a short period of time. It's going to be like a vapor. And then you're going to be 28 like me, and that's going to be terrible. But anyway, but don't worry, you're my mini-me, so it'll be good. When I can't remember what I look like, I will get you and say, hey, that's what I am, that's who I am. But anyway, this is a vapor, and it's going to pass, y'all. And this is not our home. So you have two choices. If you believe that, and you believe we have to pick up our cross and follow him, and you believe that he did not have an easy life, and you believe he suffered this terrible pain out of love, and we suffer terrible pain out of love when we don't turn around and give people their justice. Like when our heads go and we want to say things, but we bite our tongue. When people deserve things and we don't give it to them because we love them. We understand. Understanding, love, and compassion. If you believe that, I want you to open your paper back up. If you can. If you can. Because see, God likes to take us broken people and make us whole and heal our hearts. He likes to do that. So I want you to take your paper back. But if you can't and you need a new piece, feel free. I think some people can push them. You know, like when you're passing notes and you don't want to get caught by the teacher, pass the paper to those people who need it. And while I read this passage, I want you to put all the beautiful things on the back that God has given you to show you love. Just when you need it the most, God shows you a sunshine. Just when you need it the most, he shows you a rainbow. Just when you need it the most, he gives you a best friend that walks in that you never knew you were going to have. Just when you need it the most, people walk into your lives. Events walk into your lives. And let me tell you what, it's not coincidental and it's not by accident. God has a plan, and he will use it for his good. And if you believe that, I want you to start writing down all the acts of love you've seen. And some of you, the first thing you should be writing on that paper is that hug that you all come for from Miss Vicky. Now, it's not an accident that she's here. It's not an accident that she had a testimony. It's not an accident that she suffered a lot, and that's how she knows how to love others. Because she's felt when she's been hurt. She's felt God heal that pain to be able to put such a tremendous amount of love in her. Now, I want to read something to you that is one of my favorites. It might not be yours, but it is my favorite. All right, as soon as I find it. Oh, I stole their music stand, by the way. I know it. And I got their papers all mixed up with mine. But anyway, if you're on the air and you want to get out your Bible and read along with me, it is out of their Proverbs 2, verse 1 through 22. My son, if you accept my words and store up my commands within you, turn your ear to wisdom. You might want to think about that, wisdom. Write that on your paper, because wisdom is so important. And apply your heart to understanding. Indeed, if you call out for insight and cry aloud for understanding, and if you look for it as for the silver and search for it as hidden treasure, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. For the Lord gives wisdom. From his mouth comes knowledge and understanding. He holds success in store for the upright. He is a shield to those who walk in blameless, for he guards the course of the just and protects the way of his faithful ones. Then you will understand what is right and just and fair, and every good path, for the wisdom will enter your heart, and the knowledge be pleasant to your soul. Discretion will protect you, and understanding will guard you. Wisdom will save you from the ways of the wicked men, from the men whose words are perverse, who have left the straight paths to walk in dark ways, who delight in doing wrong and rejoice in the perverseness of evil. Whose paths are crooked and who are devious in their ways. Wisdom will save you from the adulterous woman, from the wayward woman with her seductive words, who has left the partner of her youth and ignored the covenant she has made with God. Surely her house leads down to death and her paths to the spirits of the dead. None who go to her return or attain their paths of life. Thus you will walk in the ways of the good and keep the paths of the righteousness. For the upright will live in the land, and the blameless will remain in it. But the wickedness will be cut off from the land, and the unfaithful will return from it. So that's a lot of passages. And let me sum it up, because I'm really good at doing that Reader's Digest version, because I'm a teacher. God's telling you, you need to start in wisdom. You need to start your day in his word, because his word speaks truth. His word speaks life. You have to understand it. It's not me. You need to go to that book and start with the New Testament. The Old Testament is hard to read, y'all. I have a hard time reading it. And I'm only 28, so I don't have many years above you. But you all are so much younger than me, and you need to start in that Bible to give you the truth. And then you start your day, because it says put on your armor and be ready. Now we all as adults, if we are a disciple, we try our hardest to show love. We try to love others more than ourselves. We try to help you. We try to put ourselves out there. We try not to get upset with others, because it's not about us. But you got to understand, there are a lot of people that it's about them. If they think they're going to go to the meeting and be unprepared or look kind of silly, they're going to be upset because it's about them. If you work with coworkers or your kids with you, they want to be better than you. They want to beat you. They get jealous. Jealous is not love, y'all. Jealous is not love. So your partners, whoever you're friends with, or your significant others, jealous doesn't mean they love you. Jealous means they don't trust you. You seek wise counsel. Wise counsel means they have to be older than you because they have more life experience. You seek wise counsel. And when we did the Fisher of Men, I told you to find three heroes, not people from TV, not people that weren't real. I said pick three real people that you have a real phone number that you can call and are older than you that can speak wisdom. Wisdom. We should start everything in his word. His word will protect us. His word will guard our mouths. His word is going to put love in our hearts when we can't. And there are many adults that are going to stand here right now and tell you there are times that we have fallen and we are on our knees begging for help and begging for love so that we can go on and go forward, because we've all struggled too. One of us that's had an easy life, y'all. So now, if you believe that and you wrote all the good things, I hope you've picked out some beautiful things that are easy things. It's that person that just sits there and smiles at you. That person who just had a kind word for you. It's a person that came up and had the be bold enough to say, hey, I love that shirt, you look great today. It's that person who said, can I help carry your books because I see you got a broken leg. It's that person that came up and hugged you. It's when the radio comes on and your favorite song just happens to come on. Do you think that's coincidental? No. God knows what you need. And if you're a music person, he'll put that song just there. I want while you're doing this and you're still finishing up, because I know I'm kind of running out of time a little bit. I want that song that I picked out, my crazy love song. All right, now, while you're finishing up and kind of debating in your head, did she just tell me a bunch of crazy stuff because the speech is about crazy love? Is what she's saying real? Did I really read from the Bible? Are those really passages? And do I have the ability? Now listen to this. Do you have the ability to take this paper when this is done and really say, and after this music's over, to really pray? Pray, because you need some extra. You need to get that right with him. You call upon him and ask him specifically, heal what's broken on my paper. Heal what I feel is causing me to have problems so I can't love. Because only you know it and only you can ask him. And if you cry out and ask him, he will answer and meet our needs. He takes care of the birds. They don't think about it. Do you think they worry about where they're eating? No. They just fly around happy-go-lucky. And so should we. So, if you believe that, any extra prayer, come up here. The altar is open and there will be adults to join you. If you don't, before you leave, if you believe anything in that what I read to you and you believe what I said, then you take your paper and pray upon it and you throw it away when you walk through that door and you don't take that hurt with you. You throw it away. And if you're not ready to throw it away because you're hanging on to it, then get up here and get on your knees, bow down and ask God, God, heal my heart. Heal my heart. Let me love those you love. Let me serve how you serve. Let me love how you love. And we're commanded to do that, y'all. It's not too late. It's never too late. Come on. Thank you for being good and participating. And I hope that this week in the month of February, heal the hearts and let the love flow, not just for February and December, y'all, all year.
God is great.